Hi students, so in the previous sessions already we have seen the many asexual reproductive methods like the fission, budding, spore formation as well as the regeneration. So these are the methods in which many of the organisms undergo the process of reproduction. So by these methods the organisms are going to produce their young ones. So here today we have one more method of asexual reproduction, that is the fragmentation. So this is also a very unique kind of the reproductive method in which the parent body will grow, it will become the matured body of the particular organism. So after becoming matured, the body will undergo into the cutting process itself without applying any extra energy on that, without applying any extra force on that, or without any extra chemicals. So itself the body is going to cut into many pieces or fragments. So each piece or each fragment of that organism will grow as a new individual. Each piece or each fragment of that cut part of that organism will grow as a new individual. So just think how wonderful this concept is. So here we have one example, that is the Spirogyra. So this is the one complete body. So this is the complete body. So it is matured body of the Spirogyra. So with the help of some enzymes which are present inside the body, or the hormones which are present in that body, so with the help of those chemicals, this will undergo the process of cutting. So each part of that organism will grow as a new individual. So it will cut here. So this part will become new young one. So this is the middle portion. This will become a new young one. So this is the last portion. This will become a new young one. So like this, the process of becoming the fragments, and each fragment will grow as a new individual. So I will give you one more example here. So consider, this is the chalk. This one chalk, you consider this one as the Spirogyra. So after the maturity, this chalk or this Spirogyra will undergo the cutting or the fragmenting. So it will become the pieces. So okay, so here the complete body will convert into many pieces or the fragments. So among these, each piece will grow as a new individual. So think here how wonderful the nature is. So this is the process. So in that one, each piece of the organism is going to convert into a new young one. So really it's wonderful, no? So the process of fragmentation means the matured body of a simple multicellular organism. A matured body of a simple multicellular organism will undergo the process of cutting or the fragment. So each piece or a fragment will convert into a new young one. Each piece or each fragment will become a new young one. So here we can see this is the piece, it will convert it into a new young one. So this piece will become a new young one. This piece will become a new young one. Like this, after the maturity, the parent body will undergo the cutting. So each cutted part will become a new young one. So like that only. So these small young ones, again they will grow, they will become matured, and again this process will repeat. It will be going on again and again and again. It will be going on and it will continue its presence in the nature. The presence of this organism will be continued as usual. So this process will be going on by this process of fragmentation. So because this is the very simple type of the organism, it doesn't have any particular organ, it doesn't have any special kind of tissues. So only because of the simple structure, so this will undergo the process of reproduction by the method of fragmentation. Is it clear? So hope it is clear. So if you have any doubts regarding the process of the fragmentation, so you can send the questions through the WhatsApp number. Okay. So after clearing this fragmentation, we have one more very unique type of the asexual reproductive method, that is the vegetative propagation. So this process, this vegetative propagation, is nowadays very familiar with our life, very familiar, and it is very close to our life, because we are all know about this vegetative propagation process. So this is very famous, and by this method we are going to multiply many number of plants. Already you are very familiar with the plantation of the sugarcane, the plantation of the rose plant. So you are going to cut the rose plant, and that cut part of that plant, if you put in the soil, and again it will grow as a new individual. You are going to make the pieces of the long sugarcane, and it will become a small piece. And if you keep that in the soil, if you provide the essential material for that sugarcane piece, so that will grow as a new individual. So this is nothing but what the vegetative propagation. So here vegetative propagation means the vegetative parts, either it may be the leaf, either it may be the root, or it may be the shoot, any part of the organism, if you provide the better the atmosphere for its growth, it will grow as a new individual. That is called the vegetative propagation. So in that one, some different methods are there. So what are the methods and what are the importance? So how the process is going on? So that we will discuss that one in the next session. Thank you and have a nice day.